Hey there everyone, this is Asinju again, and this time we're going to be diving into the common skills for Dragon's Crown and Dragon's Crown Pro. For the ones that aren't interested in the commentary and just want to go straight through to the skills, I also have an abridged version of this video that will be linked in the video as well as in the description. The first common skill we will talk about is Slide Attack. With Slide Attack, each point you invest will not only increase the knockdown chance for said Slide Attack, it also increases the distance and the speed of the slide. Higher levels of slide attack can give every class a reliable way to handle some larger mobs, as well as giving them another form of mobility that also has an attacking hitbox attached to it. All characters can cancel into their slide attack from their square attacks, but some can benefit from canceling the slide into other attacks such as the elf. The elf can slide into charge up shots, which can be a reliable way to hit a target or a mob with all of your arrow volley. Another fun thing to note, a higher level of slide attack can be valuable for an Amazon that focuses on neck splitter, since it not only does more damage on knockdown opponents, there's also weapons that you can find in Mirage Tower that can up the damage of neck splitter, and there's even more gear that can up the damage on knockdown opponents, and all of that can stack with itself. One of the coolest things to add about slide attack is you can get special equips from Mirage Tower that can give slides an elemental property, such as fire, ice, or lightning. You can legitimately be a Chinese ninja warrior with a heart so cold, aka Sub-Zero. These are actual lyrics for a song of his. This can net you easy freeze properties even if your base weapon doesn't have this. As for the skill points, the first level of slide attack increases the power of your slide by 30, increases the knockdown chance by 30%, and increases the slide distance by a little bit. At max level, the attack power increases to 60, the knockdown chance increases all the way up to 100%, and the slide distance increases by a large amount. This skill maxes out at level 5 for 11 skill points total. The next common skill on our list will be Wealth to Health. With Wealth to Health, you get a very straightforward healing passive that lets you regen HP for every coin that you pick up. There are many ways to heal yourself in Dragon's Crown, such as food, potions, runes, equipment, and the like. With Wealth to Health, you can add even more options for keeping yourself alive in dungeons that are literally showering you with coins on a consistent basis. A few important things to note, single coins and bags of coins have the same heal value, so if a coin will give you 10 HP back, a whole coin bag will also only give you 10 HP. Wealth to Health is not the same as the dwarf's Trinket Maniac. Trinket type treasures that add to your score will not heal you with this skill, only coins and coin bags. Depending on how you like to play the game, this skill can be very beneficial. Mobs frequently drop coins, which can mean consistent healing in each room. Also, if you're a fan of the Dwarf, you can stack Wealth to Health and Trinket Maniac so you can get healing from all the loot that drops from mobs and the stage. In terms of skill points, the first level of Wealth to Health will heal you 2 HP per coin. When maxed out, you will heal 10 HP back per coin. This skill maxes out at level 5 for 11 skill points total. This time we're going to be talking about the skill Money is Power. I didn't realize this at first, but normally the coins and coin bags you pick up only go toward your in-game money. But with Money is Power, every coin and coin bag you grab will also go straight to your score as well. This is definitely a great skill to have for someone that's trying to push their score numbers for quicker leveling and more frequent extends, which not only give you an extra life, but can proc some strong equipment affixes as well, such as repairing equipment durability, restoring your spell usages, item usages, and sometimes clearing debuffs. A quick thing to note, I've been told by my Dragon's Crown buddy Mitsu that this is a really nice skill to have up to level 99, but after that it's better to use score prayers like the Explorer's Boon and the Trailblazer Boon, particularly if your focus is gaining levels and extends. I'd still suggest that you test the skill out for yourself and see how it feels. Now for the skill points. The first level of Money is Power will give you 10 score points per coin picked up. At the max level, you'll be adding a whole 100 points to your score for each coin grabbed. This skill maxes out at level 5 for 11 skill points total. The next skill on our list is Vitality Boost. With Vitality Boost, you increase your max HP pool per level invested. In late game Dragon's Crown, even enemies like Scorpions and Snakes can 1 and 2 shot someone with 500 HP. Having more HP at times can give you a buffer that you need to stay alive. Another thing to note, there are some equipment affixes that only work if your HP is at 999. Vitality Boost with Snacks and HP boosting equips can give you a consistent way to use these buffs on these max HP gears. In terms of skill points, the first level of Vitality Boost gives you an extra 20 HP to your max health. At the max level, you get a whole extra 200 HP to your total health pool. The skill maxes out at level 10 for 27 skill points total. This time we're talking about the skill Nutritionist. With this skill, you can increase the healing effectiveness of food, letting you heal more for the snacks that you eat in dungeon. This is one of my favorite common skills to invest in because even a single point of this is very useful, because one skill point will give you a nice boost whenever you eat snacks in dungeon. As for the skill points, the first level of Nutritionist gives you 20% more healing for every bite of a snack, and at the max level you get a whole 50% boost to the healing when you eat foods. This skill maxes out at level 5 for 11 skill points total. Next on our list is the skill Maintenance. With Maintenance, you get a percent chance to use a temporary weapon like crossbows and knives without using up their actual usages. This means that if RNG is willing, a bow with a single shot can turn into 5 shots, or a dagger with 9 stabs can turn into 25 shankings. This skill can be very useful for an elf with a backstab build, since she can paint the fence on an enemy's HP bar for longer periods of time before having to grab another dagger, if RNG is willing. Maintenance isn't just for elves that love backstab. Weapons like crossbows do decent damage, especially if you have the stats to back that up. So anyone that enjoys using temporary weapons would enjoy this skill. Another thing to add, there is gear that you can find in Tower of Mirages that increases the overall damage of temporary weapons like daggers, crossbows, bombs, etc. Getting a good combination of gear and maintenance can lead to some pretty fun and dirty setups. Now for skill points. The first level of Maintenance gives you a 20% chance of getting a freebie for every use of a temporary weapon. At the max level, you get a whole 50% chance to use a temporary weapon without consuming item usage. This skill maxes out at level 5 for 11 skill points total. For the next skill, we'll be talking about Adroit Hands. This skill reduces the cooldown of items in between usages. These items include consumables like potions, scrolls, and rings. This also includes character-specific items like spellbooks for the wizard and the sorceress, warpaint for the Amazon, and the sacrifice skill with the fighter, just to name a few. This skill even reduces the cooldowns for switching in between equipment like weapons and armor. This skill can help any character depending on how they use their consumables and their gear. It can help you better stack certain potions and skills together, like popping a strength potion with the Amazon, then doing warpaint right after for even more DPS. It can also help spellcasters use their spellbooks with better uptimes. The skill is also helpful for power smash focused builds that have you using power attack, then immediately swapping to another weapon to power attack again. Shortening the cooldown will make it so that you can do this combination again much quicker. Now on to the skill points. The first level of Adroit Hands gives you a 10% reduction to the item use cooldowns. The max level gives you a whole 50% cut to all item use cooldowns. This skill maxes out at level 7 for 17 skill points total. Now we are talking about the fan favorite common skill Evasion. With the Evasion skill, you increase the number of times you can evade back to back. Originally, I thought this skill had to do with the percent chance to dodge attacks, so I slept on it the first few days of playing this game. But even one more consecutive dodge is a godsend to any character dealing with the level of tomfoolery that goes on in these dungeons. Some characters such as the Elf and the Amazon rely heavily on extra dodges for mounting offense while increasing mobility at the same time. The Elf wants more dodges to get off more aerial charge shots before having to even touch the ground, and the Amazon can use extra evasion with Deadly Revolution to stay airborne longer if the ground is a hot mess of note, or she has to put out damage on airborne targets that her brandish cannot reach. The skill is also very important to the wizard and the sorceress for the same reason as the previous two. Extra dodges mean extra aerial spell shots and extra options while airborne. As for the skill points, the first level of evasion gives you one more extra dodge, and at max level you get 3 dodges added to your default dodge, giving you a maximum of 4 dodges. This skill maxes out at level 3 for 9 skill points total. Before we talk about the last skill, we'll need to take a quick sidebar and talk about the Seal of the Conqueror accessory. The Seal of the Conqueror is an equip that you can get for the first time that you beat the Demon King in Labyrinth of Chaos, and the first time that you beat the Ancient Dragon in the Tower of Mirages. You can also farm them from burying player bones that have them equipped in their bag. This is one of the best equips in the game, which gets stronger the further you complete the Labyrinth of Chaos dungeon. After beating the Labyrinth of Chaos's 99 floors, equipping a Seal of the Conqueror in your bag will give you a 20% boost to your attack and your defense. Elves will get a 25% boost to their crit rate. Wizards and sorceresses will get a 25% reduction to MP usage, while Amazon, Fighter, and Dwarves will get a 25% reduction to the Power Smash cooldown. The last thing to note is that you cannot stack the buff with more than one Seal of the Conqueror. The last skill we will talk about is Deep Pockets. This is another very straightforward passive skill. With Deep Pockets, you increase your maximum bag capacity by 1 each level. Without Deep Pockets, your maximum bag capacity is 7. If all of your equipment is accounted for, that will be 5 slots for equipable gear and 2 slots for potions, rings, skill items, and Seal of the Conqueror. Depending on your character and your playstyle, you may need 1 or even max item capacity to give yourself the options that you need to play how you love. For spellcasters, item slots mean more spells that you can take on adventures. Any character can bring backup weapons, shields, and other equipment to help you explore longer.
It also better enables weapon swap setups with the Power Smash, and lets you toggle between weapons with special status effects or fixes that can let you change up your playstyle on the fly.
The first level of Deep Pockets increases your item capacity from 7 slots to 8 slots. At max level, you get 3 extra item slots, increasing your item capacity all the way up to 10 slots. This skill maxes out at level 3 for 12 skill points total. That's going to be about it for this common skill video. For any of you that took the time out of your day to watch this, I really appreciate you. If anything in this video was able to help you all out, then mission accomplished. The last Dragon's Crown video I will be doing will be on the real game of Dragon's Crown, which is cooking, along with some cooking etiquette, because most of us are savages with food IRL, so it won't be any different in this game.
I can't get the... It didn't let me pick up the goddamn salt!
That's what I had earlier. Salt spells in it.
Shut up!
But am I wrong?
It's not wrong.
God damn it.
This is my life. This is my life that's in shambles because I can't put salt on my goddamn food.